the biggest challenges are really boil down to two things. I mean, in home winemaking is dealing with thermal issues and oxygen issues. And those are the major two things that feed into the problems that that tend to arise.
What is a thermal issue in home winemaking?
Fermentation, you know, either getting it warm enough or cool enough, or avoiding things getting too cold or too hot. For how long, you know, to extract appropriately from a red wine. In a small vessel, it's going to ferment really quickly. It's not going to warm up very well, probably. And it's not going to, if it does, it's not going to be very warm for very long. So it's going to be difficult to extract out of some of the more gentle tissues more thoroughly, you know. So it tends to be a different type of extraction. And then with whites, or just finishing a fermentation, it tends to get too cold for the biological activity to really to finish appropriately. Dealing with oxygen on a home winemaking standpoint with the massive grapes, basically they're going to be saturated, the surfaces will be saturated with oxygen when you destem the grapes. Let's assume you destem it all and there's no whole clusters involved, just for the sake of simplicity. So you destem the grapes, they end up in a garbage can or some sort of a, you know, vessel, a small vessel for fermenting in. The surface of this vessel is now in contact with 20% oxygen, you know, the ambient air. And so all kinds of organisms are going to thrive on this because you've given them food. You've given them something to eat, something to breathe. You may like that, but you probably are going to want to have yeast dominate this scene fairly soon. And that's, I think, where, from a functional standpoint, where inoculating with cultured yeast comes in as a very, very healthy tool, because it's kind of a race against the clock with your competitors, you know, Acetobacter and other types of bacteria, and possibly other types of yeast that are going to begin growing right there, right away. And they tend to, a lot of those organisms will tend to give off some really aggressively aromatic compounds that never fully leave the wine. So just from a functional standpoint, I think home winemaking is more difficult because there's more, the conditions are a lot more skewed toward not getting the desired outcome or noisy outcomes, as opposed to on a somewhat larger scale. I'm not talking about, you know, 15-ton fermenters or 100-ton fermenters. I'm talking about the difference between 200 pounds of grapes and a ton of grapes, you know, or more. So once you get to the point where you're looking at about a ton of grapes or half, three quarters of a ton of grapes, it's another level of scale that I think is a little easier to deal with.